I'm Lottie, and I'm a university student from England. This year, I've been studying abroad in Munich, and although Corona had other plans, I'm now back in beautiful Germany. I'm welcoming you into my life as I travel, act, interview, and laugh my way through with my gorgeous friends and family along the way. Subscribe and welcome aboard. So, I am back in Munich and obviously quite excited about it. But Will and I only have 5.5 weeks here, so we've banded together, created a very extensive bucket list of things that we want to do so we can say, yeah, we really completed Munich. So I thought we would do a little series, which will be our bucket list in action. Each week I'll take you through all the things that we get up to, and we're a couple weeks in and there's a lot. So get ready and enjoy.
It's the first time I've been in the city for about 5 months, and we're going to a museum, which feels really weird. So we've got our masks ready.
We went to Village Stuck, which is a museum and historic house devoted to the life and work of the painter Franz Stuck. But as we somehow always manage to do, Will and I ended up in a very peculiar exhibition. Abstract art at its finest, and quite possibly its weirdest. Our first time at a cafe in several months, and oh my goodness, have we missed German cake. We're at the Nymphenburg Palace today, and although it's a 20-minute walk away from us, I haven't been yet. Apparently, it's one of the premier royal palaces of Europe, and it used to be where the former rulers of Bavaria spent their summers. The main hall was so sumptuous and decadent. I really just wanted to be in a big 18th century ball gown dancing around in it. Descendants of the Wittelsbach are still allowed to stay here, and behind this door are their private apartments. I'm rather jealous. This was one of my favourite rooms. This is where King Ludwig I had paintings of all of his mistresses. He has another amazing gallery in the other wing, called the Gallery of Beauties. He certainly wasn't secretive about his mistresses. We then ventured outside into the beautiful Nymphenburg Palace gardens.
God, that's right.
They even have gondola rides along the water.
It's very Sound of Music-esque.
The hills are alive!
Oh my god, this was a little find.
They've got apple. Honey, they've got apple.
We're getting apple.
I can't believe how beautiful this cafe is. Until Will said this.
I just killed a bug.
After lunch, we thought we'd go and explore the other historic buildings in the palace park. Will really struggled with the word Pagodenburg.
Pagodenburg.
And the Monopteros too.
It's the Monopteros.
The Nymphenburg Palace Park covers an area of 229 square kilometres. So although Will and I gave it a good shot, we didn't really cover much ground. We then went into the Badenburg, which has these beautiful, sumptuous fabric wallpapers of Asian landscapes. It also has the first heated indoor pool of modern times. It was the public bathing scene for the court's enjoyment.
That is incredible. This whole thing is a bath.
As our final stop in the park, we went to find Magdalenenklause.
Might be abandoned.
It's a bit scary.
But unfortunately, all we really found was an abandoned looking building that ended up being closed. And that was the end of our day in Nymphenburg. Will and I decided we wanted to visit the Dachau concentration camp.
Arbeit macht frei. Work makes you free.
It was established on March 10th, 1933, and became the prototype for Nazi concentration camps. In the course of Dachau's history, at least 160,000 prisoners passed through the main camp, and 90,000 through the branches. Incomplete records believe that at least 32,000 of the inmates died there, from disease, malnutrition, physical oppression, and execution. But countless more were transported to the extermination camps in German-occupied Poland. If you ever get the chance, we would both really recommend going to this concentration camp. The exhibitions there were powerful and necessary to see. Dachau was liberated by American troops on April 29th, 1945. As we were in Dachau, Will and I also headed over to the palace gardens on top of a very steep hill.
Doesn't look as steep on it, but it's so freaking steep.
On the way, Will discovered the most beautiful secret passageway that led to an amazing view across Dachau and even all the way over to Munich. We could even see the tower next to where we live. Will led the way up the hill, as ever, until finally we arrived at the palace, its view, and its gardens. The palace garden was created from 1572 to enjoy the amazing view from the castle on the hill. It's been through several redesigns, starting first as a French garden, then moving on to a Baroque style, and in 1765 it developed into an English landscape garden, with precious fruits and flowers. Westpark is one of my favourite places in Munich, but Will had never been, so I thought I'd show him around. It has Japanese and Chinese gardens, a Nepalese pagoda, Thai and Tibetan temple, and if that wasn't enough, it also has beautiful lakes. A huge rose garden, which is in full bloom. It even has its own amphitheatre.
What are you performing for us today?
Will and I decided after all the excitement of the last few days, we would just take the day to relax and sunbathe. But of course, when Will and I decide we want to relax, the grey clouds come over. Now, this is a niche one, but Will and I really had a hankering for fish and chips, and especially to try them in Germany. And you know what? Not bad. The Deutsches Museum is my favourite museum in Munich. It's actually the world's largest museum of science and technology, with about 28,000 exhibited objects from 50 fields. No wonder Will and I spent over 4 hours in there. It's also the largest museum in Munich, And for a while, the museum was even used to host pop and rock concerts, including Jimi Hendrix and Elton John. I just love how interactive the museum is.
We've got some good bands.
And it's an absolute rabbit warren, so you can get lost in the exhibitions for ages. The Isar River has historically played an important role in the region for trade and travel. But for us, the river is simply a lovely place to trade the streets of Munich for trails while enjoying the beautiful views. The riverside walk stretches many, many kilometres along the Isar. We even ended up in part of the Englischer Garten. And were graced with an amazing jazz musician in one of the urban art tunnels. God, I love Munich.
So that was week one of our Munich bucket list, and 8 items ticked off. I think it was a pretty good start. Join us next week as Will and I go to an outdoor cinema, check out more castles, of course, and go to a few lakes as we tick off the items on our Munich bucket list. Much love.